Hello then, welcome to another educative episode of AAU Talks on AAU TV. We always say that we will inform to transform the African continent. I'm your host today, Agyemang Okyere Darko. You know, about a year ago, the blockchain program was introduced in Accra Technical University to educate the students and the general public about the power, the disruptive power of technology, and also put the country in a position to train its youth to be a bridge of technology. Today, the dream has come to pass where we have members from the Hague University in collaboration, or members from the Accra Technical University in collaboration with the Hague University on how this dream or this promise is being real. Don't go anywhere, we're right back.
Are you an institution or individual? Do you intend to organize a memorable event to be archived for future reference? Then look no further than AAU Studios, because it's your best bet with our spacious studio and state-of-the-art media equipment such as 4K Panasonic video cameras, KinoFlow lights, assorted microphones, live streaming equipment, among others. You are sure to get the best of productions. Visit us at Trinity Avenue, East Legon, adjacent the National Accreditation Board, or contact the AAU Studios via the following email addresses: info@aau.org, aautv@aau.org, or ransford@aau.org. Alternatively, you can call us on +233 244 736280.
Welcome back. If you just joined us, it is AAU Talks on AAU TV. I'm your host, Agyemang Okyere Darko, for today. And I have with me members from the Hague University and also the Accra Technical University, a wonderful collaboration. And I want to start from right close to me is Professor Dr. Theo Bosma from the Hague University. I also have Mr. Irene Dungio from the Hague University and Mr. Frank Oponifrimpong from the Accra Technical University and Dr. Philippe Van Pembroke, also from the Hague University, and Dr. Ernest Wilfo from the Accra Technical University. Nice people, you're welcome to AAU Talks.
Thank you. Good to be here.
Wonderful. This morning, great news, great collaboration. Africa seeks to engage in more collaborations with international universities, and therefore ATU is one great news to hear. So we'll begin right away from how it happened. How did it happen with the Hague University and Accra Technical University for Dr. Ernest?
Thank you very much. I think we all bear witness to the fact that the velocity of change and the intensity call for collaboration. Sure. If universities and international, if university and academic institutions are to remain relevant to the continent.
Sure.
For that reason, we looked for a strategic partner that will really help and impact on our delivery. And for that reason, we have ATM, Hague University, which we started collaboration about 4 or 5 years, and moving from one step to another. And today we are here, and they are to help and guide us to be able to match the velocity of change in the education industry.
Great. Let me do a quick switch to Prof. Dr. Bosma.
Thank you.
What is the purpose of your visit to Africa per se, and also to the Accra Technical University?
Right. Well, actually, when you introduced the program, you said something about making an impact. And I think we started with Accra as at a first level partnership. And I'm very happy to say that yesterday we agreed on the strategic partnership.
Sure.
And strategic partnerships are very important for us. And actually, we look for people who have the same heart. And basically what we have together is make an impact on students here in Ghana and make sure that whenever they graduate,
sure,
they have the best tools, they have the knowledge in order to become very young, successful professionals.
Great.
This is what we call like a match made in heaven.
That's amazing. Yeah. So let me go to Mr. Rene about the concepts, ideal that will make our viewers understand why we're having this show on the issue of blockchain. What is the power of blockchain here?
No, the power of blockchain is to share information. We started with this company called Coils, which actually we believe education should be free and accessible to anyone. So going back to blockchain, blockchain is a technology that assures transfer of value. And value could be money, could be identification, certification. I'm going to give you an example. Here in Ghana, there's a problem with land registration. People are fighting all the time. Suppose we were to use that technology and then to assure that the piece of land that is sold is certified, and then no one else can claim it. So this blockchain actually assures that transparency and that trust.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what is the benefit for the students who engage themselves in this training?
Very good. So one of our mission is, as I said, education should be free and accessible to anyone. I came from a poor family where you could study is expensive, and also in Ghana, only rich parent can afford to pay the tuition fee. But what about if we create a platform where you don't have to pay anything? There are many other platforms that provide, the MOOC, what we call MOOC, massive online learning platforms, right? We're different because our platform is totally free of charge. You can study any course you want. We started with blockchain. We're going to move on to many other courses. Could be finance, accounting. It is totally free. So that's the power of blockchain. Now, someone will say, you don't need blockchain for that. But when it comes to certification, that's where blockchain comes, to assure the transparency and the trust of the certification.
Great. Let's move to Mr. Frank. You know, the sound of blockchain sounds so fascinating to the African continent, but the question is, are there any practical things going on with our industries in Africa, particularly in Ghana?
Yeah, thanks very much. Blockchain is highly disruptive, part of the fourth industrial revolution, key aspects, which is taking the globe by storm.
Sure.
In Africa, I have examples. For example, when you go to Kenya, we have this mobile, money called M-Pesa.
M-Pesa.
But then it also graduated to the Bitpesa.
Sure.
Okay, which facilitates transactions. Huge volume of transactions don't need to go through documentation. Is that okay?
Sure.
At a global level, key giants in ICT, IBM, Microsoft, Accenture, all of these are into blockchain. There's a big hype around it, but we need to see the bigger picture and what it's doing. And Africa needs to tap into it. You come into Ghana, we have corporate entities like Stanbic Bank, Vodafone. Yeah. They're all trying to experiment with blockchain technology. It's at a nascent stage. But with time, the big picture is that it's going to deliver a lot.
Okay.
So talk about areas where we can apply it: finance, land title registration, agriculture, education, security, very important. Dubai, by 2020, wants to go fully blockchain. Government transactions are going on the blockchain so that it will be open. And Dubai is saving about $3 billion yearly from the application of blockchain. Why can't we take advantage of that? And so we need to take off from that. We want to be the strategic player in academia. And with the partnership from Hague, I think there's a lot that we can do.
Right, a lot. I can see that. Also, Dr. Van, let's talk about the kind of collaboration we're looking at having here with the ATU. What kind of collaboration is going on here?
Well, actually, my students in Holland, they have access to arguably the best higher education system in the world. And upon graduation, basically, they have a very bright future. And we would like to offer this bright future also to the local Ghanaian students. Like my colleague already said, it is very important that education is not a privilege of the rich. It is a basic right for basically everyone. So what we would like to do now is to develop and to deliver education together with ATU. My university is a pioneer in the field of blockchain. And it is an incredible opportunity for us to share this knowledge, this expertise with ATU, such that their students will become the agents of change in the future. They can help Africa to make the transformation to the new circular economy. And I think this is a very good opportunity for both of our universities.
Great. So what do you expect out of this collaboration with ATU?
Well, for me, it is very important that we can share our knowledge, we can share our expertise, and not only that we come here and we will do the education. Now, we also want to become a strategic partner such that the lecturers, the professors, the researchers here at ATU, they will gain the same level of expertise as my researchers in Holland, so that they can independently also contribute to the development of blockchain.
Great.
So, John, to add to it,
sure.
Currently, they are having the blockchain run in Hague. And Accra Technical University is also going to start running programming blockchain.
Sure.
What we want to also do is we are trying to let the student from Hague and Accra Technical University, we are going to bring them together and they'll be working on similar project. Mm. So we expect a lot to come from it.
Right.
That synergy, the students learning the culture from there, learning the techniques from there, and I think it will go a long way to help Africa.
Right.
If you look at the blockchain countries that really are using the technology, you see Africa is totally black. This blockchain is just coming like the way internet came. And when internet was coming, Africa was lost out. It is now that we are trying to even catch up with the internet. And it's really very difficult. Blockchain is the new one that is coming.
Sure.
So if we do not accept a move with it, by the time we realize Africa is out. Most of the times we mention blockchain, I try to talk to students with blockchain, they always bring about the negative aspect. Mm. See, blockchain, the Bitcoin, somebody is going to do all sorts of things. I remember the very first year, last 2 years, somebody came and instantly wanted to register students. And that was wrong. For everything that is good, you have people coming to be smart. Mm. So most people in Africa look at blockchain, link, and Bitcoin in a negative aspect. But there are a lot of positive aspects.
Okay.
And that is what we're
sure. If you just joined us, African AAU Talks on AAU TV, and we're discussing blockchain technology and how it can impact the youth of Africa. Don't go anywhere, we'll be right back with more of this talk.
Egypt is well known for ancient culture and rich heritage. But its rapidly growing population presents a challenge: how to provide enough jobs for those entering the workforce. One way Egypt is addressing this situation is by encouraging more entrepreneurship. President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi has challenged young people to become part of this solution. In response, many of Egypt's educational institutions have launched entrepreneurial training programs. Alexandria University is a great example of this.
Welcome back on AAU Talks, and we were talking about blockchain technology before we went for the pause, and let's come back to Mr. Rene. You look so good in your t-shirt.
Saying Koyos, what is it about?
Yeah, as I said already, Koyos is a platform where we intend to open up the education. We're not here to disrupt the education. We're here to facilitate, to make the education better,
sure,
accessible to anyone, everywhere, customize your learning. Suppose you're from Tamale and you want to follow a course at Accra Technical University, in this case, blockchain, but you don't have to travel to Accra for that. Staying at Tamale just with your tablet or your mobile phone, you can access all the information online and for free.
Mm. You know, there are a lot of continents out there. You chose Africa and Ghana. Why?
Look, I'm from Africa.
Exactly.
My heart is here.
Sure.
And I know I've been through many, many things. Trying to learn to get the education, it's never been easy. And then having this technology that's going to change life of millions of people, I'm always very excited, very emotional when I'm talking about this. So why Africa, why Ghana? I came here 2 years ago and I noticed that many kids were not able to access the education. And then we started with Mr. Winfo brainstorming about how we can use the technology to make this better. And then we're happy that it's realizing we came here to deliver the promise that we promised 2 years ago.
Great. Mr. Frank, currently in Ghana, are there some industries in Ghana who are living up to the prospect of blockchain?
Okay, like I said early on, we have industry players coming from real estate, and then we also have the financial aspects, okay? But it seems like looking at what's going on, the real estate has very good promise. Acquiring land for developmental purposes, you know, is a serious problem,
exactly,
because land ownership is full of litigation. But when you have a system that is basically open, the blockchain, you have what we call the private blockchain, then the public blockchain. Is that okay? Mm-hmm. Afterwards, as a country, to take advantage of either the private or the public or even the hybrid. And so if you have land registry or ownership being registered on the blockchain with immutability, transparency, then we can trace ownership, the benefits. If you want to get a mortgage with the bank, then easy for them to get you a loan.
Okay.
Is that okay? If you want to start any business development activity in Ghana and land ownership is very clear, then very, very you can also start. At the international level, we have international development and we have donor partners. But one key problem we have has been corruption. So the money is coming in any countries where the money is going. But we have examples where the World Food Program has been able to deliver food to refugees. The beneficiaries actually got the money. What the blockchain does is to digitize, for example, the dollar in the form of tokens. So it eliminates all intermediaries and cost comes down seriously. So if we can implement some of these things in Ghana, actually we are going to be the better for it. Talk about supply chains. We can take advantage and then supply chain and logistics can also go very well for Ghana. Okay. But for land, we have some companies starting. We have, for example, Bitland Ghana is in this system. We have had IBM also come in. But Bitland is starting in Kumasi, and people are registering their land. So it's on a pilot basis, but overall we hope that it's going to be replicated in most other regions in Ghana.
Great, splendid. Right. So at this moment, I'll pick your final words, and let's see if there are further prospects that we should know or the world should know.
Yeah, thank you. On the 27th of this month, that's February, we are having a big program in Accra Technical University on blockchain.
Okay.
And the main aim is to invite business players, our partners, and also make students available. This business people from the industry are really coming to tell us the practical problems that they face in the industry. For example, we are expecting Ministry of Agri to come.
Great.
And they will be telling us about planting for food, the government's agenda, and all those things. And as they tell us the story, the students or the audience will be mostly students, will be listening to the challenges. And then at the end of it all, we expect the students, we'll group them into groups of four or five, and then they'll be using the knowledge of blockchain to address these challenges. We don't want a situation where students will just go and sit somewhere and frame a problem and then use blockchain and do it, or frame a project, a topic, and then try to do it. We want live problems.
Okay.
So 27th, we are inviting industry players. Come tell us some of your problems. We have people around, and then the student pick the problems. We have experts who are going to guide the student throughout. We are going to link some of these students also to partner students in Hague University together to see how they will successfully come out with a solution to some of the problems.
Great.
Then there will be, after 4 months' time, we expect the successful group to make the presentation. And at the end of it all, we'll see what happens.
Great.
Yeah.
So, Dr. Van, what should we expect?
Well, basically, I'm very excited that I was here to bring my research and my lecturers, and they can work together with the counterparts here at ATU, and they can inspire the students. Yeah. So yesterday, we had our first kickoff, and I can see that the students are very interested. Yeah. And we have a very special way of teaching. We think it's very important that we start with the context, with the practical implications, business solutions, business problems, and then the students will look for a real life solution. And I'm really excited, looking forward to see how all these very bright students in ATU will come up with nice solutions for our companies.
Great. Mr. Frank, any words, any last words?
Yeah, I think that blockchain is highly disruptive and we can't stay behind. Africa has got to be shown up when it comes to radar pointing to countries which are using it. So come 27th, we're going to roll out what the expectations should be for key stakeholders, for students, researchers, government, industry players. We're all coming together. And we see how we can take advantage of this highly disruptive technology.
Great.
So I think that we should all come and then see how practically we can roll out the blockchain program.
Great. Right. Mr. Rene?
Yeah, I would like to invite you all to visit our website, coils.online, to really get access to the our stuff there. And then we invite you all to this event on the 27th of February from 9 o'clock. It's open up. It's open. It's free for everyone to join. So you're welcome.
Great. Prof. Basma.
Yes, thank you. Well, I'm responsible for internationalization, and I can already say that this trip has been quite a success. I mean, we have closed agreements with the right people. We have talked also with AAU this morning, and we discovered that we have a lot of synergies.
Right.
And actually, we invited AAU also to participate in a key role in our African summit in The Hague in the Netherlands. And from there on, we can see how many more agreements we can have. And for the viewers, actually, if you want to participate in the African Forum, let AAU know, and then we can send you an invitation as well.
Great. Thank you, gentlemen, for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for watching and sending your comments to this program. It's all about blockchain, and on the 7th February, it's happening live at the Accra Technical University, is how students come together to exhibit their skills in blockchain. It will be nice. Thank you very much for your time. My name was Agyemang Okyere Darko on AAU Talks. We will inform to transform. Keep watching AAU TV, and bye.